Welcome to the channel. And today we're going to be doing a little bit of playing around with this cube to see which setup, like in the magnets and spring strength, is good for me. Okay, so it comes with these magnet strings here. And we got yellow, green, and these white transparent ones, which have no magnets. The green ones I think are weak, yellow are medium, and the one in it I'm pretty sure the strongest you can get. So I'm gonna see which magnet strength is the best for me, at least in my taste, and which spring strength is the best for me. And I'm just gonna play around and see which one is the best for me. So, first, I'm going to do a couple algorithms after I get the one I want on there. So I'll do it with the regular strong ones that come in it. So, the only problem about these magnets, I feel, is it's really, really just, like, how do I put it? It just sometimes will take a lot of force to get it spinning, in my opinion. But, it still works good. I don't think it's my favorite springs, though. So, I guess we'll just work down and put these yellow ones in. Okay, so these are the yellow ones, and I can definitely feel the difference. I don't know if I put the weaker ones in. This feels pretty good. I mean, it still has a lock in it, but I can tell a lot more that it either won't turn as much, or turn more, I mean. And it's a lot. It's not as locking into the turns. Got a couple algorithms here. Okay, so I'm not too sure about the yellow magnets. We'll try the green ones and see how those fare out. So these are the green ones. And I don't know if these are stronger than the yellow ones, but they definitely feel stronger to me. So an algorithm. I would use these green ones. They feel really good. To be honest, it makes the cube really smooth. And yeah, I could try the transparent ones, like the complete transparent ones, but they don't have any magnets, so I don't know what the point is. I just feel like that would make the cube really unstable and not retain a shape that good, because there's nothing stabilizing it. But I guess I'll still try. Thank you. Okay, guys, so here is the null magnet, and to be honest, I just can't. I mean, it makes middle turns and side turns pretty easy, but, like, it just feels so unstable, and you can even see it on camera. Compared to everything else, everything is just going out of place, and I don't really think that's optimal. But the movements are still pretty smooth. It's just, it, Q feels very unstable, and like it's about to fall apart. So, I'm going to get these green magnets back in, and we'll test the spring strengths. So, yeah, get into that. Okay, guys, so with the green magnets back in, that means this is my personal favorite out of all the magnets. Now, is it the best? No, I just think it's the best for me. Now I gotta put all the magnets back on this ring because apparently taking them off is gonna leave open spaces. I'm just kidding, I already knew that. So I'm trying to stay really maintained with all this so that I don't lose pieces. I hope you guys know what I mean. I'm also gonna try and talk to this part about stuff. So, all I know, according to now, about the spring strengths is I'm pretty sure the blue ones are a little bit, like, taller in length, so it's going to put more tension on the spring, which is going to make the cube a little bit tighter. So I think the one I have on now is going to make it less pop resistant, and the other one will just make it tighter. And, of course, if it's a tighter cube, the pieces are closer together, so you have more pop chance. Other than that, I think I'm just going to keep it with the same spring strength, but I might adjust it a little bit. I don't know what I'll adjust it to, but that will be for me to find out since this video is all about experiments. And all done. And we got our little color wheel. Okay, so these ones have magnets, these ones have magnets. These ones don't. Can I speak? Okay, so I'm gonna put that in there. Put the case on. And we got that seal. Okay. Now I gotta get these off, and I've never done that before. But it should just be. Well, almost got it, I think. I think is the key word. Hey, there we go. Okay. So these have two notches as well. I'm pretty sure. Three notches! Holy! Oh, these have three notches as well. Okay, so let me just push that in. I'll do that. Okay. Spins a little bit more freely. What is the difference in these? These aren't really any different. I guess it's just the sinking spots. Because right here we have 1, 0, and 3. Here we have 2 and 4. On 4 and see how that goes. I don't actually know. I don't really feel a difference, but that could be because I'm just new to cubing and I'm not really noticing anything. But so it's on one now, so if I take this off, guys, this mechanism is so cool. Okay, I guess I'll switch all these over to 4 on these bigger ones, and we'll see what happens. So I got it set on 4, and as of now I can't really tell a difference, although it does turn a lot smoother in my opinion. But I guess I'll see what this does in different strengths. Okay, so that must be really tight. That must be really loose. Get it to really loose. Okay. Okay, that didn't really take any time, but now I guess it's really loose. Oh, I can feel that. That's a U3, really. It's only a U2. Spins so freely, oh my gosh. I think I'll keep it a little bit tighter though, it'll go like 3 down. Okay, so these are the settings I like. It's a little bit tighter than normal. And it turns pretty smoothly and has a nice look. So I'm going to get these caps back on and talk to you a little bit about this cube after a little bit of testing around with it from yesterday. So this cube is just really a step up. Granted, it's $50 compared to, what, $10 for a regular cube. I mean, you're of course going to get more for your money, but like, it's just the quality for $50. I mean, granted, when I bought this, I got all this case and all these extra adjustments and all that, but it just feels like they put time into their cubes instead of just assembling a cube and saying it's good, which I just think Rubik's does, because they don't really care about how it performs. But if you get a GameCube, you're gonna notice that quality difference, in my opinion. And it's just amazing how well it performs compared to any other cube, and how smoothly it is compared to any other cube. But I guess I'll do a quick solve right here and see if I can get a faster time than normal. I will put all my adjustments in here. And I'm also going to be getting some lube and another pouch today. Probably another pouch for either the cube and the 2x2. And then lube, or another case for the spare parts. So I will get a scramble going here and we'll get a solve going. So here we go, we're going to get a quick solve. And I'll just keep talking, I guess. So more about this cube. It is just a dream to use. I mean, if I had to recommend a cube, it would be this one, but there's a lot better cubes out there, I guess. But this is just quality to me, since this is my first real speed cube. So it's pretty new to me to do this. So, a few turns, this thing is a little faster than it previously was. But that's alright. I mean, that's how I want it, you know. I hope you guys don't mind me talking, but I guess I'll stop talking and put a time lapse in right now. Okay, so there we go, that was a cube. That was actually a pretty fast solve, for me, at least in my case. But, Other than that, I am gonna start learning F2L and stuff like that so I can get faster at solving the cube. And yeah, I think that's the end of this video. And without further ado, goodbye.